8 hours in a day. No, eat alternate days a week. No, eat only once in a day. Confusing, right? So today, I am going to jump into the science of intermittent fasting and get my hands dirty. Keep on watching. Hi everyone, I am Manisha Mehta, your own clinical dietitian and sports nutritionist, and you are on my channel, Renourish with Manisha. We are here making fitness easy for foodies. First of all, I would start by apologizing for the change of setting and the change of lighting, because it's a particularly gloomy day. It's raining since really early in the morning. We are in the mid-morning and still there is no light, but anyway, let's jump into the concept of intermittent fasting. Let's start by defining what intermittent fasting actually means. If I Google the term intermittent, it shows that it means irregular or erratic or not continuous. And fasting, as we all know, is the state when we are not eating anything. So intermittent fasting means that we have some periods of fasting in between our eating cycles. And if we look even this much closely to it, we would realize that intermittent fasting is nothing new for us. When we are sleeping, we are anyway doing the intermittent fasting. That is why breakfast is called break fast. And if I talk about the history of intermittent fasting, all the major cultures of the world have some sort of fasting in their rituals itself. Hindus have Navratri or the weekly fasting. Muslims have Ramadan. Christians have their Lent fasting, in which they fast for 40 days. But in intermittent fasting, we are basically using a systematic approach to starving so that we can tap on the fat reservoirs for energy, and hence it will lead to fat burning. Now, intermittent fasting, or IF, uses our natural system of feeding and fasting cycles. When we are eating, it's called the feasting or the feeding cycle. And when we are not eating anything, that's the fasting cycle. Now, when we are eating, our body burns down the food to the form of glucose, which is utilized by our cells to create energy. Whatever extra glucose is there, it is stored as the fat reservoirs with the help of liver. And during the fasting cycle, the same fatty acids or fat reservoirs are broken down to create glucose for the fresh energy. But in our regular eating patterns, our body never reaches that level where the fat reservoirs are required to be broken down, because it takes a minimum of 10 hours of not eating anything before our body can actually tap on the fat reservoirs for energy. So intermittent fasting basically tells us to not eat anything for 16 hours so that in those 6 hours, our body will be burning on the fat. However, how quickly your body will start to burn fat as a fuel will depend on your activity level. For sedentary people, it will take around 10 to 12 hours. For active people, it might happen earlier also. So summarizing what is IF, it is not a diet. It is a lifestyle approach. And if we look into our ancestral eating patterns, they used to eat by the sunset, and then the next morning meal used to be after the sunrise. So anyway, they were at the intermittent fasting, but there was no fancy term around it. Now, since the time science has started intervening into the concepts, researchers have found out that intermittent fasting can actually help us lose fat, maintain our blood pressure, increase our insulin sensitivity, increase the human growth hormone, and improve our brain function. The major positive hormonal changes which are seen during the intermittent fasting are the insulin sensitivity and the human growth hormone. Now, human growth hormone is actually present in all the human beings, but the highest levels of it are in the teenagers and in the younger adults, because that's when they are supposed to increase their height, increase the muscle mass. So human growth hormone is actually responsible for all these things, and it is also responsible for the muscle repair. And insulin, on the other hand, is like a gate pass for glucose to enter inside of the cell so that cell can make energy out of it. And the researches done on the intermittent fasting have shown that the people who are on IF, they have a massive spurt of human growth hormone in them, and they have a higher insulin sensitivity also, which means that less of insulin will work more for them. Now, how does all this happen? See, our body is equipped to deal with any kind of condition, and starvation is one of the extreme situations where our body will have to fight to survive. But starvation, the actual starvation, can happen only after 4 days of not eating anything. So when we are not eating anything between 12 to 16 hours, we are basically posing a potential threat in the front of our brain that we might not get anything to eat. And that's when the hormonal readjustment happens, and that's where all the potential health benefits come from. Because at that time, our brain will be in overdrive, our brain will be creating all the positive changes faster so as to prevent the starvation. So basically, doing intermittent fasting kind of puts us back into our adolescent stage, where we used to have massive energy, we used to have very quick muscle rehabilitation, and we used to have high energy levels all the time. But it all sounds too good to be true, right? There are disadvantages also, and not everyone can do intermittent fasting. These things I'm going to discuss just in a while. But before that, I want to share how and what are the ways to do the intermittent fasting. So there are majorly four ways of doing the intermittent fasting. First is that you eat only once in a day. Second, when you are eating for 5 days in a week, and then 2 days you are going on a liquid diet or you are going on a very, very light food diet. Third, when you alternate between days of normal eating and fasted eating. And fourth, and the most common one, is not eating for 16 hours and eating for 8 hours in a day. Now this whole thing sounds too good to be true, right? You do not eat anything and then your body will turn into a superhuman and then you will be able to do everything you used to do in the adolescent. But that's not exactly how it happens. When you're not eating anything for a very long time, there are researches which also suggest that your cortisol level, your adrenaline level, which are the stress hormones, may also rise, which means it's not all the bed of roses. And then there are people who go to the extremes of not eating anything for 18 hours or 20 hours, which might not work with everyone. Let's discuss who all should not do it. Firstly, pregnant ladies and lactating ladies at no cost should do intermittent fasting. Second, people with diabetes should not be doing intermittent fasting because they should not go for that longer period without eating anything. Third, children and teenagers should not be doing intermittent fasting because when you're doing intermittent fasting, by the nature of the pattern itself, you will be eating slightly lesser calories than you normally would, and children and teenagers have massive energy requirements. Fourth, people who have any sort of eating disorder like anorexia or bulimia should not be doing intermittent fasting because it will be hard for them to control on that urge of eating, and if they are already eating very less nutritional food. Fifth, people who are underweight. Sixth, people like me and my clients who are foodies, who want to enjoy life and do not want to go for that long without eating anything. Now let's discuss the disadvantages of doing an intermittent fasting. There are majorly three disadvantages which are there of following an intermittent fasting plan. Firstly, there is not enough right guidance available on how to do the intermittent fast. That is the reason why people also go to the extremes of not eating anything for 18 hours or 20 hours, where they might be depriving themselves of so many nutrients because of the lack of calories and the lack of nutrients that they have. Because if you're eating for only 4 hours in a day or 6 hours in a day, how much nutrition will you pack in the maximum of 2 meals that you're going to have? Plus, what people fail to realize is that the trigger that we want to click for the fat burning will also be clicked in the 10 to 12 hours of fasting. So you do not need to go to the extremes of 16 hours or 18 hours. The basic agenda here is to make our brain realize that we might go into the starvation so that all the positive changes can be kicked off. And because of this lack of knowledge, people also think that in the eating window, they can eat anything. But that's not how it works. Because in the eating window also, you have to eat the nutritionally dense foods. You have to take care of your calories. You have to take care of the calorie distribution and the nutrition distribution. Because if you fail to do that, the repercussions will be just like any other junk food diet. And third, your social life will take a hit. Because if you're not eating anything for, say, 16 hours, that means there's a high chance that you'll be missing either dinner or breakfast with your family. You might be missing a lot of family gatherings. You might be missing a lot of friends' day out. So if you really want to go through that, then go ahead. I can't, so I stick to either a 12-hour or a 13-hour fasting. Now, getting inspired by this video, if you really want to start the intermittent fasting, there are a few tips which I would like to give you so that your intermittent fasting is smooth and healthy. First, you have to put nutrition on top of everything else. Because if you're not eating nutritionally dense foods, if you're not taking care of the enough calories that you require, the same thing will happen if you are following any other random crap diet. Your muscle will not be repaired properly, your sleep cycles will get disturbed, the glow of your skin can suffer, the hair quality can suffer. So you have to really pack a lot of nutrition in your eating window. Second, you have to hydrate really well. And that goes without saying, that goes with any kind of lifestyle. And third, when you're coming out of your fast, start with a fruit so that you can absorb all the nutrients of the fruits properly, and also it will give a kick to your metabolism when you start eating. Now, whatever research papers we have discussed today are linked in the description box. Now, if you liked this video, which I hope you did, and if you want to help me in my agenda of taking simplified science of fitness to everyone, then take a screenshot of this video and share it on your social media, on your Instagram, and do not forget to tag me. And if you did like this video, then I'm sure you're going to like these two videos as well. And about this video, please write me in the comments below if you have any questions and if there is something particular which you liked about this video. And I will see you next week on the same channel. And I love you unconditionally. Bye. Keep on watching. What was this?